Hi, welcome to this How Do I video in the extension series, in which I will show you how to include a permission set in the Microsoft Dynamics NAV extension. At the end of this video, I'll have added a permission set in the extension that we created in the video How Do I Build a Basic Microsoft Dynamics NAV extension. It might be useful to watch that video first. The idea is to extend the extension with a permission set, because we have added new objects with it and need to make sure that people that want to use the extension can also grant access to these objects. We will do this in three steps. First, we'll prepare the permission set, and we will do that in PowerShell. Next, we'll export the permission set. And finally, I'll show you how to include it in the extension. So, let's first create the permission set. It makes sense to do it with PowerShell, because in that way you can automate the process and the extension is not dependent on the data in the permission set table in your development environment. Basically, you need two commandlets: new NAV server permission set and new NAV server permission. Let's take a look at this script. In this example script, you see how we would be able to create a super permission set for the newly created extension object. It's now time to export the permission set to make this available for our extension. In a way, we need to add it to the NAVX file. As you have seen in the video, How Do I Build a Basic Microsoft Dynamics NAV extension, we need to export deltas to a folder and reference it in the new NAVApp package commandlet. To add a permission set to the package, we need to export it to the same folder as the deltas. We do this by using the export NAV permission set commandlet in PowerShell. Finally, we can now create a new version of the NAVX file. Because the permission file was in the source folder, it will import it when you publish the extension. Since my environment already has an extension from earlier time, I will first uninstall it and unpublish this extension. Then, I'll publish and install the new version of this extension that now includes the permission set. So, when you publish and install the extension in the test environment and open permission set page, you'll see that our permission set is now available to use. In this video, you have seen how to add permission sets to an extension by creating it with PowerShell, export it to the Delta folder, and including it in the package. For more information on extensions, please visit this link on the Microsoft Dynamics NAV Learning Portal. Thanks for watching, and see you soon in another How Do I video from the Microsoft Dynamics NAV Extension Series.